We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Wow. Thanks a lot, Captain.
Wait a minute. What happened?
No, we our lovely partner in Vision over here.
Melanie. She was sitting next to me 2 seconds ago.
I've been having a sneezing fest, so I felt like that I really could do the show. Even Van Eric, come on now. You were here. Wasn't I sneezing up a storm?
Melanie, come here real quick. Come here, mama.
Yeah, we're going to have her make
we still
a cameo.
Want her. We still want her to be
come
seen.
On. Come on in
okay,
here. Come
because
on,
let me tell you something about this young lady. First of all, hey, how y'all doing?
I'm Talk Live Radio.
I'm Trisha Mann Grant.
I'm Ro Williams.
Yeah, yes.
I'm Melanie Levy.
And this is, come on down. Come on down. Right here. Sit right here for a second. There you go, girl.
You got to sit in my
chair. All right. She can sit in my chair. Thank you. All right. So here's the deal. Melanie, as of 30 seconds before we went on air, was actually going to be our co-host for the day because my co-host here, my partner, she's not feeling well, y'all. So if she gets to sneezing and coughing and doing some crazy stuff, we're going to send her back over there.
I'm going to get fired.
And she, yeah, because she better not make any of us sick up in here today. Melanie, say hey to everybody.
Hey, everybody.
And you know, one of these days we will have you on the show, you know, co-hosting. And tell everybody what you do real quick.
I'm a student at Loyola Marymount University. My major is sociology and my minor is African American Studies, and I'll be graduating in May.
She's so articulate and so bright.
I taught her everything she knows.
Yeah, yes. So what do you want to be when you grow up?
You know, that's an interesting question, but I'm not really sure right now. I'm still testing out the waters and seeing what I really like to do and what sticks.
Okay.
She'll be our boss one day. That's probably what's going to end up happening.
Hey,
you know mad what? At that. Just pay me more, girl. Just pay me more.
Make that money.
Right.
Make
thank
that money.
Thank you, ma'am. Got we appreciate you for being available.
Yeah.
And hey. All right, girl. Did you take some medicine and everything?
Yeah, I took some allergy pills because that's what I was feeling that it was. But, right. You know, I don't know. But I even said, Van Eric, you're my witness because I kept sneezing and it wouldn't stop. Like,
and I see he's got it. It's pretty cool up in here. But
yeah, man, they always like to hang meat in the studio with us. So I'm not really understanding why because we're
it's all good. That's why I came prepared. Got the jacket.
Well, in the meantime, thank you for joining us. This is our entertainment edition. The last couple Sundays. If you've tuned in with us, man, we had some awesome show. It was actually a rebroadcast of an awesome show that we had with Shiloh, man. Those brothers.
They're ridiculous.
When we go out to commercial, we're gonna go out to their first single, and they are just some amazing together brothers. The song is called "All I Have," and I mean, if you listen to the lyrics, they're an R&B group, secular group, but these are brothers that have some good morals, even when they talk about the woman that they love. It's this virtuous woman in the song. I mean,
they're young.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what I loved about it. It was they're young brothers that really have it going on, and they're together, and they're spiritually together, and they're sincere about it. You know, it's not like they're putting on a show or anything. Mm-hmm. So we appreciate you guys for coming out last Sunday.
And one of them was even married. Speaking of marriage, we'll get into secrets. But yeah, he was married, and his wife was in studio.
She was here, and she was supportive, and they were trying to keep it on the hush.
Yeah, but I loved how you and your husband had a little mentoring ministry.
All of us,
after
look,
set.
All three of us, because you were getting it in. You were letting
them
know.
Well, yeah, you know, I was a little upset because I mean, as a journalist, I felt that was newsworthy. You know, I'm like, hey, we could have had that on the air.
But you know, back in the day, you know, Babyface used to tell As Yet, you know, and that's the group that Tony, my husband, was a part of. He used to tell As Yet and the guys, look, don't tell people you were married. And at the time, Tony was married to someone else. And he told people anyway on the radio. He's like, yes, I am married. And the women loved it even more.
I know. Like, what is up with that mindset to think your stock is going to go down? The sad part about it is it really goes up.
It goes up.
Everybody wants what they can't have.
Exactly.
You know, and nowadays, we're going to have to talk about that because I bet you that's what's a part of some of the secrets in this topic of the day.
day.
Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something.
I'm just about to be a reality show.
Let me tell you something about secrets, okay? Not only, and I so mean this. I've been blessed to be a part of some great productions with wonderful cast members. But
I would say this is about the finest one, though.
There you go. Help her, Jesus.
I'm sorry.
Touch a man.
I'm so glad it's cold in here. Praise Jesus.
I'm sending her pictures and bios of all the brothers in the cast, and
she asked me, "Do I feel like to do the show?"
I didn't. I'm healed in Jesus' name. I'll be there. That's a single Christian woman.
Should have on a Hyundai.
We gonna pray for her saints. Come on. So anyway, the members of this cast, and first of all, let's start with Wallace DeMario, who's the writer, director, producer. He's also acting in it. He just handpicked a wonderful group of actors and actresses, and I can't wait for us to get everybody. Well, some people aren't here, and we'll explain that later and give them some love too. But this show is about secrets for real. And the thing about it is, y'all, we can't be holier than thou and act like we don't have stuff and bones in the closet and secrets in our past and situations going on. And that's why I chose to be a part of this, because it's really real. It's a little raw. I mean, there were moments I was like, okay, should I do it? Should I not? But it's raw, but it keeps it real because it's life.
But life is raw. And I like the way it was worded. You know? It's a raw graphic portrait of a failing marriage.
Right.
And I don't know that any marriage that's failing is not something raw and yeah. You know what I mean? It's who falls cute? It's like Buster behind, and you're like,
true?
It's like there's nothing pretty about, you know what I mean?
It's funny. I had a wonderful breakup one time, and the actual breakup itself was like, check it out. Well, I suspect, but the actual breakup itself was like, well, you know what? Hey, we're gonna be friends, we're cool, yeah, I love you. And then 2 weeks later, that's when the stuff hit the fan. That's when it was crazy stuff going on.
I mean, the truth really began to unravel.
Everything just started coming out within the 2 week period. And I'm like, whoa, the actual breakup date was beautiful compared to what I'm experiencing now. So, you know, like you said, it may start off that way and end up somewhere else, but it's never going to be pretty.
It's never pretty, but mm-mm. I got to say this, and then we'll toss the commercial, because we really want to give them the bulk of the time. And when we come back, we're going to sit down and have a one-on-one first, so you can get into the fine mind of the writer, director, actor, producer of this project. And then we're going to meet the beautiful cast. They could be a group in themselves.
Guys in the house. Joey Cinco is in the house. Trey Ireland is.
And they are all beautiful. Like, they can be on a reality show just called, you know, Beautiful Theater or something. But I got to tell you, I had posted this clip maybe I'm dating myself, but I say Nickelodeon, Carol Burnett. It was a little vignette. She was in the bed, and this was back when she was in one bed and her husband was in the other bed, because they wouldn't show two people in the same bed. And the phone rang, right? So he answers it and puts it down. And so she's like, who was that? And he's like, it was a wrong number. And she was like, And she kept going on. She would not let it go. She was like, it was code, huh? It was a code, huh? It was a signal, huh? Who was it? What's her name? And he was like, what are you talking about? It was a wrong number. Why are you tripping? Go back to bed. I got to get up early. And then finally he gets up and closes the window. And then he gets back in the bed. And she was like, oh, was that a signal too? was that a signal to let them know, you know, that it was, that she wouldn't be meeting them or something? Mm-hmm. As they waiting out in the street. And he was just, and it was hilarious. And he just kept saying, you are tripping. Baby, you know I love you. Just go back to sleep.
So was that remind you?
Wait. When she went back, well, allegedly goes back to sleep. And he goes back to sleep. And he just looks up and he gets up and he gets out. He has his street clothes on underneath his pajamas. And he heads to the door. Next thing you know, she gets up with the shotgun. Is like, shh, take another step. It was hilarious. I mean, that's definitely not a cute take on cheating, but for that little vignette
So what are you telling everybody, to get a shotgun? Is that what you're saying?
No, I was just saying how that, you know, back in the day they would put a cute spin on a really tragic concept.
Let me tell you something. I used to watch her. It's comedy, right. But she did it a little bit different. So you had that kind of get a fabulous black.
I set up comedy
to it.
And we're gonna let Mr. Wallace D Mac, or what you call him, set up the tragedy aspect.
Yes.
So that's all I'm saying.
Yes. Oh, and there is comedy in it. Believe me, you are going to laugh. There is lots
especially
of comedy.
Especially if a sister is like, let me tell you something.
Mm-hmm. That's right. So
that's probably where the comedy come in. Your mama brought you in, but guess who's about to take you out.
I'm so proud of you. You haven't sneezed or coughed one time.
Well, that's I give that up to
Jesus. Jesus. You know, she ain't sneezed at all.
Well, we got to come back. We got to go pay a bill. And when we come back, we're going to sit down with the cast of Secrets.
All right.
No shit. Tell everybody. Secrets. Tweet, Instagram.
Facebook. Email. Text.
And I guess I won't be
open
selfish.
Open the door, the front door, and yell at your neighbors. Whatever you got to do.
Right. And I guess I shouldn't be selfish. So if you want to call in and talk to any of the fine cast members, 323-473-3100.
What's the number again?
323-473-3100.
Mm-hmm. Call us, y'all. Williams. You're going to want to talk to these people. Trust me. I'm Trisha Mann Grant.
This is GospelRhythms.com. Talk Live Radio. And this is All I Have by Shiloh. Check it out.
Somebody needed something, we gave it. Yeah, we didn't think about it twice, lady. And now that the lights are turned out and all of our so-called friends are gone, now all that I have is you. Now, baby,
all I have is you.
All that I have is you. I lost my job, lost my car, you were there. Lost the house, lost your ring, girl, I heard. Then you looked me in my eyes, told me everything would be alright. I'm so glad God blessed me with you, a virtuous woman, a love so true. All that I have.
It's your man Dane Webb, host doing the most on LATalkLive.com. Dane's World, every Saturday, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. It's HLA, every Saturday. Check me out. If not, you're lame. Y'all be cool, live free. Check me out. iTunes R&B, Live 365, Facebook, Dane's World, and Twitter, Dane's World. Ustream.tv, Dane's World. Y'all be cool, live free. Enjoy your day. Peace.
Hello, I'm Joel Ramirez.
And I'm Lolita Robinson Coppage, and welcome to Joy in My House
on LATalkLive.com. Inspirational radio
with a touch of recovery.
A reality show where nothing is left unsaid
and no one is insignificant who says it.
Exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV.
reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hi, this is John McClure Jr., a.k.a. Simply John, and I would like to invite you to join us on GospelRhythms.com every Sunday at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, for our show, GospelRhythms.com Talk Live Radio. Join us as we celebrate Christians around the world in all genres of entertainment, as well as highlight interest stories on men and women who are making a difference and impacting their community. So don't forget to tune in to GospelRhythms.com on LA Talk Live. And we're more than just talk. Remember, it's a heaven's party here on earth. So live life. Love God.
This is J. Nicole. And when I'm in LA, I'm listening to LATalkLive.com. Exclusively on LATalkLive.com and the Talk Live Broadcast Network. You can also catch them on iTunes Radio R&B. TuneIn Radio, Live 365, Radio Flag, and AHA Radio, or watch and listen directly at LATalkLive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Had money, had cars, had fame. House in the country, took long vacations. Whenever somebody needed something, we gave it. Yeah, we didn't think about it twice, lady. And now that the lights are turned out, and all of our so-called friends are gone, now all that I have is you. Now, baby.
Hey, welcome back to GospelRhythms.com, Talk Live Radio on LATalkLive.com, Entertainment Edition. Yes. I'm Ro Williams.
I'm Trish Mann Grant. Hey, y'all. Happy Sunday.
Yeah, happy Sunday. That, again, was Shiloh, our guests that were in studio a couple weeks back, the awesome R&B group, Amazing All I Have. That song is talking about paying tribute to the great woman behind the great man. And it's amazing because the topic of our show today actually is the anti-All I Have. It's All I Don't Want to Have.
All I Don't Want. Well, actually, they had it and just kind of messed it up.
Well, what is it about that? I guess we'll find out.
We're about to find out once we talk to Mr. Wallace DeMaria. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the amazing writer, producer, director, and actor, Mr. Wallace DeMaria. I'm a hurt.
Just saying.
Bring it down.
323-473-3100.
Wow. Okay. DeMaria, but thank you.
I knew that.
I just knew. Wait. Don't say she pronounced the name wrong.
Yeah, we go way back.
I didn't say that.
It's
usually the one that does that.
See, I'm clearly not that fine. DeMaria. She didn't remember my name. Hey. It's okay.
DeMaria.
It's okay. It's
y'all
okay.
Just heard something else. That's all. I'm just saying DeMaria all this time. All these
you don't
years.
Love me. That's really what it is. You don't really love
okay,
me.
Okay, you know
what
I need you to do? I need you to put an accent mark.
It's supposed to be one, but everyone forgets it, so it's okay.
But no, that's your resume.
This is your resume.
That's your resume.
Did you see?
That was the man did that. Okay, they're trying to keep me down.
They're trying to keep you down.
They
took your accent away.
It was the man. And these days, the man could be any color.
The man, right? I didn't say what man. I just said the man.
These days, so let's just talk real quick. Okay. Your film. Let's talk about the film. You've been in Another Kind of Valor, A Simple Promise, The Key, On the Waterfront, Finding Madison, Cuddle Buddy. Let's not talk about that one.
Yeah, don't talk about that.
And TV. You've been on Conan and Trent and Tilly and Forensic Files, Live Like a Star, Dinner and a Movie. Oh, that sounds like fun. MTV and Urban Sketch Comedy. Theater.
Yes.
You were in this play with me called Men Cry Too.
Yes,
Miss Brandy Burks. And we did. Yeah. And Trees and The Twelfth Night. What was one of your favorite productions?
The next one. No, just
the color of museum.
You are whichever terrible. One I have next. The that's slaves, the one I love the most.
The color museum.
I love them all, man. They all had different things. I mean, I'm very selective about roles. I don't just take anything because I feel like your work will live on longer than you do.
Yes.
So I want to be remembered for great things, you know, not just for me personally. And that's not a shot at anybody who does. But I don't want just to say, well, hey, I did 100 projects this year. If I'm ashamed of 90 of them, you know what I mean? Right. So everyone that's on there, man, I loved it. I picked it for a reason and I had a great time.
No Attack of the Killer Tomato work for you. That's great. You know, be selective because a lot of times people, meaning actor, and you might be able to identify this, they so want to fill up their resume, especially starting out.
Right.
They just want, they'll do a whatever. Right. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I
was blessed enough to meet a couple of legends. And so like Denzel Washington and different people. And everyone kept saying the same thing. Be selective. You know, your work will live on longer than you do. Some people will never get the opportunity to meet you and talk to you. So the only way they're going to know you is your work, your body of work. So I just wanted that to speak for me. Whereas if you know, when it's all said and done 100 years from now, if you look me up, you would get a good feel of who I am by the projects I selected or that I created. So
Well, let's talk about your writing though.
I want to give our audience a portrait of the man behind the work. There was a journey that brought you to this point.
Writing is the craziest one ever, honestly. I never thought I'd be a writer. I never wanted to. It felt like work to me at first. And then God just has a way of orchestrating things sometimes. So here's the series of events. I'm in a movie, A Simple Promise. So it screens at Warner Brothers. And Brent Jennings, who's been in the industry forever, looks me up, finds me in a play. And he says, young brother, I like you, man. I saw your movie at Warner Brothers. I have no notes for you. And that's very rare for young actors. And I was like, oh, wow, thanks. And he goes, you remind me a lot of D. You work like D. And I said, who is D? He said, Denzel. And I said, oh, man, get out of here. That's too big. And like, I immediately blew it off. And he got upset. He was like, I know him. That's my friend. And when I say you work like him, I know. And I was like, oh, okay, I didn't mean any offense. Well, a week later, I meet Denzel. Like, we meet and have a conversation. And so he's so funny because he's very much Denzel. So as soon as I said, Mr. Washington, because you forget you're grown when you're talking to him. Your friend. He said, who's my friend? Who is he? What's his name? I said, Brent Jennings. He said, yeah, Brent Jennings. Yeah, he's a good brother. What's your name? I said, Wallace DeMar.
You didn't pronounce your own name, Rob.
Who am I? Hold on. Let me see my wife.
He's intimidating, basically.
I felt like I was talking to my father. And he's very much, I mean, I felt like I was in Training Day or something. He said, what's your name? And then he said, I heard about you. He said, I heard you're doing good work. He said, can I give you some advice? Yeah, you're doing well.
Please.
He said, if I knew at your age what I know at my age, I would have spent a lot less time auditioning and more time creating work for myself. You understand what I'm saying? And so I'm like, well, if the icon just said that, then of course I'm going to think about it. And then just to make sure that I did, I ended up with a hernia right after that. And I had to have surgery and I was just down and I got this idea. And so I called every writer I knew. I was like, yo, I got this idea. I'll tell you, just I need you to write the script. Everyone was like, no, I'm not writing it. Write it yourself. I was like, but I'm not a writer. They were like, how many scripts have you read? I said, 1,000. I don't know. Well, write it. And then a friend of mine said, write it and send it to me. And I said, for what? Why am I sending it to you? She said, do you know what I do? I said, you're an actress, right? She goes, Wallace, I'm a script supervisor for studios. Send it to me. And she corrected it. And that's how I learned how to write scripts, was making all the notes that she had made. And then after that, you know, you just start to create worlds, and no one was creating the type of projects that I wanted to play. So the first one went out and the response was huge, and then it just kept going. And then I fell in love with it like I did acting. I mean, I was not only creating work for myself, but opportunities for incredible artists that I knew. So
that's great. That is really a great story. See, and you got you and I were talking. You have testimonies. That's another reason I want you to come on the show.
Lord.
You have like personal testimonies.
Yes.
And I know we discussed it a little bit. You didn't mind sharing.
Yeah.
But if you could just real quickly tell us about when you were homeless.
I was heavily recruited, man, like an athlete coming here. I was actually a graduating senior at Fisk University with a job offer at IBM. Me and entertainment had fallen out as a kid. Like, it had hurt me bad. And so I didn't want to go back. And a professor in school was like, why are you here? You're a brilliant guy. You're one of my best students, but why? this isn't where your heart is. You when you talk about acting and entertainment, it's something totally different. A light comes on. Mm-hmm. And then my girlfriend at the time started saying the same thing. So she talked me into going to this competition in Atlanta, Georgia. And it was 5,000 people showed up there, and I was the only person selected by a major agency out here. And, you know, okay, move out to L.A. And I'm like, okay, that's my other home. Not a problem.
Well, and this was for writing, right?
No, this was for acting.
Oh, for acting?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was 5,000 people there auditioning with different agencies. No one was picked up but me. And I said, well, I'm in school. They were like, oh, it doesn't matter. You're fine. Finish out your semester. Then you come after that. Hollywood is dead. I talked to the woman that signed me every day until I left. Even as I drove across the country, I got here, went to her office, and they were like, she was fired a month ago.
Wow.
And we don't know you, and we're not signing you. And I was like, I just dropped out of school, man. Like, I just drove all the way across the country, got rid of my apartment, sold all of my stuff. You're playing. They were like, we don't know you. And then I had relatives here who I had talked to who were like, oh, yeah, you can stay with us. And then they were like, oh, you were serious.
Oh, that's
like terrible. People say they're coming out here all the time. Yeah. We didn't think you were serious. And so, I end up, man, homeless. Not only homeless, I used to sleep in my car at Dominguez Hills. I used to pull in there because there were so many cars there. Security would never check. And I used to tell God, like, if this is all you have for me, you can take me home now. But if I wake up tomorrow, then you have a purpose for me. And every morning I would wake up, and that's what I'd be like, well, woke up. You must have a reason. I had a nervous breakdown. I don't mind telling you. I ended up walking down the middle of Crenshaw screaming. I literally challenged God to a fist fight, and I'm so glad he didn't take me up. But I had read about Jacob, and he wrestled with him, and I said, well, hey, box with me. I mean, give me a chance.
Baby, let me tell you something. Your arm's too short to box with.
Oh,
God.
I would have lost.
he just left with a limp. But you know what? I had just posted that sometimes God will dislocate your hip to get you into the plan he needs you to be.
I will tell you how powerful it is. I'm just crying and I'm screaming. I'm walking down the street. What did I do to you? I didn't do nothing to nobody. And then I couldn't take another step. I was done. I was spent. And I was standing right in front of West Angeles Church of God in Christ. And I just was like, this must be a sign. And I walked in and I sat in the back and I sat there for 8 hours straight. And I don't know if God told everybody just don't mess with him because no one threw me out or said, hey, man, we're kind of working right. They just let me sit there. And I sat there and I sat there and that became my church home. And then I said, I'm done. I'm done with entertainment. I actually went back to school and got a degree in Christian leadership. I was going to go work for God. Just, hey, I obviously have made you mad. Let me. And one morning I woke up and I was crying in the middle of my sleep. And I just woke up and I was like, why would you make me so good at something and love it so much and then tell me I can't do it? And as clear as I hear your voices, I heard him say, I didn't. You just put it before me.
Wow.
That's heavy. That's
oh, my goodness.
Heavy to the 12th.
Amazing.
Power heavy. I love it. That's a great testimony. That's what I love. I know I say this a million times. I know you're sick of me saying this, but
what?
I love testimonies because it's the good and the bad and the ugly that makes it such a blessing for other people to hear.
No, it's just, and this that's is the our bottom story line. That
you know,
his glory.
It could have happened 55 years ago, but it's still going to be a blessing to somebody that hears it today. It blesses me. You
well,
know?
I've always believed that anything you go through and survive is not for you.
No, it's not.
Somebody
not
will
always.
Need what you went through. They'll need that later on.
Right.
So
sometimes you'll need it later on. Sometimes we have to reflect back on the things that have happened to us in the past and go, wow, he got me through that, and that.
Right.
So why am I tripping about this?
Right.
When I know if he did all that, then I'm going to be all right.
Right.
And sometimes he just simply wants us to trust.
Yes.
Just trust and say, okay, it's cool. Right. So let's talk about your cast. Let's talk about, first of all, Secrets and what inspired Secrets.
How this baby was birthed.
Well, I mean, the divorce rate in our country is like 50%, and that's Christian divorce rate as well. The numbers are almost identical.
Mm-hmm.
Clearly, marriages are struggling. People are having, you know, a hard time in them. And the thing is, you're taking two people who are going to grow, who are going to change, who they won't be the same person at point B that they were at point A or at point C that they were at point B. And how do you make those grow together? You know, people, everybody runs, trips, falls in love. How do you stay there? Mm-hmm. How do you deal with it when you're not in love anymore? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Do you have that foundation? I've seen so many divorces. I've had one myself. And some divorces or some breakups that were, you know, they've been together 10 and 11 years and then it ends horribly. And I don't know. I just wanted to take it and say, you know, take it and put it on just the highest stage. I always say I take normal situations and then put them on steroids. That, mm-hmm. as a writer, that's mm-hmm. what I do. And so I wanted to take this and use it not only as just for marriage, but in life. I mean, the biggest point with secrets, man, is say what you need to say to people when you have a chance to say it. My mother says, give people their flowers while they can smell mm-hmm. them. You know, so that's, I use marriage because it was two people or whatever, and most people could relate to it, whether they've been married or been in a relationship. But it was bigger than that. It was more of say these things. You know, you love somebody, call them, tell them, because you might not get a chance to tomorrow, mm-hmm. you know?
Right. And you said this was based on a true story, yes? Loosely.
It's a composite of a lot of stories, honestly. Mm-hmm. One thing I found is that regardless of why people were breaking up and everything else, usually the foundation was the same.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Lack of communication.
And mm-hmm. that just grows and grows and grows. And what ends up happening is these two people who were this close, I mean, this inseparable, they start to fill this huge space in between them with all the stuff they're not saying.
Mm-hmm.
And then at some point that takes on a life of its own. So,
and we're going to get a female aspect because we got Miss the beautiful and talented, sweet, lovely Miss Kanique Sky. She's in the house. She was on American Idol.
Yeah,
but we got to put the camera on her, but I'm just letting you all know she's here. She's going to come in.
Very beautiful. And I mean, the cast is like, y'all, they can all be models. Look to your right. I know, I'm the camera. I threw a ball at him because he was like being Apollo Theater over here doing shout outs. Yeah. Tell about that movie. I forget which one he was saying. I was like,
now that he's here, I can leave. I'm good now.
Also, and let's not forget about the also handsome, but yet Joey? he can switch it up and be eerie for us too. Like, yes, as you'll see in the play, Joey Cinco
is
in the house
is a
as
cutie
well.
Too. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, go ahead. I know you got to ask him.
No. I was going to say we're going to come back because we want to get all the cast in because there's so much meat. But what I was going to add was mm-hmm. that Mary. Oh, yeah. You may need to come a little closer with your mic. Yeah.
Yes.
But because we want him to hear every drop, you know, because I get that this is this wonderful play that has such an attraction, that almost like a reality show, because that's the thing. But it's ministry. And I love how, you know, even the poster, I'm like, betrayal, secret, lies, pain. It just the poster. I thought it was a film or something. I was like, I need to go see that.
Yes,
like,
and it's coming, right. Glory.
Amen.
Yes, it
but,
is.
But you know, with marriage, it's like, you know, it's supposed to be a model of Christ's love for the church.
Yes.
And it just, and no, it must break his heart when, you know, I recently went to Vegas with my girlfriend to celebrate her birthday. And, you know, her and her husband were going through some things. And, you know, they're now going through a divorce, and it was just heartbreaking because you know she doesn't want to,
right.
But at one point, like you said, you know, you may be going through, maybe that time of the month, there may be whatever it is that caused you to feel like I'm tired of this, but
right.
Feelings are so deceiving, you know
right.
what I mean? And you
right.
can't, as our pastor said today, make a permanent decision
on a temporary circumstance.
Mm-hmm. Although on that note, we'll probably need to let that marinate. Say that, and I say that right, because
yeah.
you know,
right.
you
don't
know,
make.
I asked the Biblical Institute brother over here, make sure I say the correct pronunciation. That's why I look. Say that. Meditate on that. When we come back, we're going to meet the cast. A secret.
Right.
Beautiful cast.
We'll be right back.
But don't shush. Go tell everybody.
All right. I'm Trisha Mann Grant.
I'm Ro Williams.
Gospel Rhythm, y'all.
Talk live. Woohoo. See.
Shadows of my life keep flashing before my eyes. I'm remembering how much I always loved the Lord. Even when I was a child, I knew to call on the Lord whenever I needed a friend. Call on the Lord in my time of need. Call on the Lord. Ooh,
faith in the Lord. I knew that He could do anything. I knew that my life should revolve around Him. And I knew all of the Lord, whenever I need an offering. All of the Lord, in my time of need. All of the as I remember all the things that He's done for me, and all the things that He's brought me through, and I'm just so thankful that I know to call on whenever I need an offering. Call on the Lord in my time of need. Call on the Lord. Ooh. Call on the Lord whenever you need a friend. I know sometimes you feel like everything you do is in vain, 'cause the whole world is driving you insane. But you need to
says you have no idea.
Ah, there we are back in the mix, girl. This is gospelrhythms.com talk live radio. It's no secret we got secrets in the house. I want you to tell everybody and let it out. I'm Ro Williams.
That's right. I'm Trisha Mann Grant, and I'm so happy to be a part of this cast, The Secrets. Secrets. It's not called The Secrets, but they got a lot of secrets going on. So first of all, let's just real quickly, you want to introduce everybody?
Yeah, my side of the table. Your side. Powerhouse vocalist, woman extraordinaire. Go introduce yourself. Oh yeah, got a baby.
Hi, I'm Kanique Sky.
Yay, Kanique! Woo-hoo-hoo. And you are?
Oh, that's how the introduction I get.
You gotta give it up for you. Gotta give up a tray. Hold up.
I'm gonna say a little bit.
I'll say a little bit, and then you say, "Look, this is our show. We get to do what we want to do. You can say
it. Why you got me on that?
In Jesus' name, you know what?
He likes it. Don't worry about it.
Wait a minute.
I told you.
My engineer had all my paperwork, so you know it's teamwork makes the dream work. All right, go on, handle, girlfriend.
This brother's from my hometown.
That's right.
Chi-town. Now, no, you don't get to say nothing now.
Did I not know this?
You gonna let her?
Chicago native. Trey Ireland is an actor with an impressive list of theater, TV, and movie credits.
I did a laugh track. I'm not there yet. I thought I was.
So let's just get straight to the point. You are Moesha. You were once and again JAG, film winning, the award winning Coach Carter. Hey, that's good. I know you on there. Okay, the comebacks, Breaking All the Rules, and
whose resume?
Trey Ireland. No, you're not gonna come up in here causing havoc. Go ahead, you read some more. Cause
well,
I'm
no, hungry. I mean, I was gonna, you know, you went there. I pulled hers up because
I was gonna give some
because you know we just can't just leave her hanging. You know,
well, we're not gonna leave. I'm just saying, hanging on
my, this is to my right, okay. Kanika. Did I pronounce it right, Kanika?
Kanik.
No,
Kanik.
I told you, let me pronounce people's names.
I know, right? I just
Kanika, Demaria.
I'm fine.
She made me say Demaria. She made me.
But check this out. Don't matter. She is a veteran of the stage, right? Film and screen. That's what I'm saying.
American Idol. Oh, I'm sorry. You go ahead.
No, she finished as a top 13 finalist in the mega hit show American Idol, which we did mention. Soon after, Kanik won the Dream Girls competition sponsored by the, how you pronounce that?
Amundsen.
I knew that.
That's right.
Theater.
Here.
And BlackWeekly.com. You actually were the recipient of several NAACP awards. It was three out of seven, nominated for seven. Hey, I remember that.
All right.
I mean, she's just awesome, a beautiful, gorgeous, statuesque, vocalist, talented woman of God. Yes.
She actually inspired me to start writing plays. Her play that won all those
awards. Sunday.
Sunday morning.
I will never say anything behind people's back that I won't say in public. And I told her the first day I met her, she inspired me to start writing plays because she got on the stage and she's crying, thank you guys for coming.
Was she really like that?
Yeah, she was crying and she was like, she not hard, don't let her play you. And then she was like, this is my first play. And I didn't hear anything else after first play. I was like, well, you have no excuses.
Wow.
The best show of the year. So.
And I can't wait to find out what motivated you to write Sunday Morning, which was the recipient
of.
Well,
we do have another person to announce.
I know. We're going
to talk to
Kanik
and ask her about all of that.
Okay, she just stuck a pin in it. We're going to put our paws.
Kanik Scott was sticking a pin in that and get to Joey because I have something to say about you too. All right. So Joey Cinco, who I've had the pleasure of. Oh, there we are. I've had the pleasure of working with on this production only. But I'm going to tell you something. Let me just say this without reading this real quick. Yeah. He's a beast. Like a beast. Everybody in his cast is a beast, but he's like Quiet Storm kind of beast. Would you guys agree with that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Just amazing actor. Every rehearsal, he pulls a rabbit out of his hat that you just weren't expecting. And I'm blown away each time. And it's such a, and I'm not even, we are in a couple of scenes together, but we don't have, you know, much dialogue, but we do get a chance to sit there and elbow each other. So that's fun. Okay, he was born to Jewish Italian Americans. He grew up with a strong love for acting, raised and born in California, exposed to theater at a very young age, and he's taking pictures right now. I love it. And he acquired his first play performance at the age of 8. And as Joey's continued involvement in plays blossomed, he went on to attend the California Conservatory of the Arts. You've been in A Letter to Marty, Best Short, and LA Fear and Fantasy International Film Festival. What was the biggest thing you've done that still stands out in your mind? Which one? It's so much stuff. A Letter to Mary? That's what you can talk
A
now.
Letter to Marty is what I'm most fond of. Other than the play,
okay.
I'm in right now.
All right. You know what? I'm going to try to make this easy for you and share my microphone with you. How about that? Because Wallace is like, yo, I'm not trying.
Yeah,
to share
you know.
Thing.
I like Joey, but I ain't like him that
don't
much.
Like
you know
that.
What I mean?
Okay. So Joey, are you having fun working on Secrets?
I love working on Secrets.
Yeah.
It's
why?
Terrific. Because everybody's so talented. And everybody has such an honest approach to the craft that, you know, that's something I like being a part of.
Who's going
to
say no but Wallace right here anyway?
I love Secrets.
Yesterday. Yeah. Like, who's going to say no right now?
Yeah, right. Trey, since you're talking.
Word is that. I beat my actors, okay? They better say good stuff. No, I'm just playing. That
my
is
mama
a joke.
Was a
just
beat
a threat. That's enough.
Eat the cake.
But yeah, instead of talking about my resume, can we talk about my pink headphones?
Oh, I thought that was fabulous. Yeah. Like,
I did.
I think this is so cool. And you wear it well. Give me some. You're wearing it well. Yes, it is.
We shouldn't lie on a gospel show.
I think he looks great.
Because he stands out from the rest of us.
That is so funny.
But A Letter to Marty.
Anyway.
Should I talk about A Letter to Marty real quick?
Yes.
Yeah. A Letter to Marty was a short film I kind of wrote as an actor, kind of like what Wallace did with this. you know, you get inspired, you start writing, you try and do stuff different. But I was going to a film festival for one of my short films I was in, and I knew I got word Martin Scorsese was going to be there, and I met him. We filmed it, and I had a good moment. I thought it was divine. I was at the right place, right time. Gets out of the car, comes over to me. We exchange a few words, and I had it on tape, so I built a short film around it. And that's one of the things I'm proud of. Nice. And you can watch it on YouTube, A Letter to Marty Scorsese.
Okay.
But other than that, Secrets is the best thing ever.
Wallace
slipped some money under the table.
No, it wasn't money. It was a jab. Like your role is secured.
He's like, here, take this and say something nice.
Well, we're gonna get the lady.
Let's get a lady.
Yeah, first.
Go ahead, baby.
Now, with this production, Secrets, tell us about your character. Have you ever been married? How you can relate? You know, all that stuff that we want to know about role.
Marisha. Marisha, to me, she just represents all women. You know, it's not even about, it's not a race thing. It's not a status thing. It's just a woman who desires to be loved, is in love. And she tried to curtail some of the issues that she kind of foresaw when she met him, but he was very persistent.
Now, is this her husband?
Her husband, okay. Who eventually becomes her husband, which is played by Wallace DeMarianco.
I could not resist. How I get treated.
That's sad. That's
sad. I'm so sorry. It's got to be a running joke now. Yes. Sorry, Wallace. We got to do it.
How about the Mario? Why not?
DeMarianco.
Thanks, Kanika. Kanika Knight.
No, Kanika.
Kanika, whatever. Kanika Knight. Thank you very much.
Maria.
Okay, y'all.
No, but seriously, so she's I got you, bad girl. She wants to be loved, but there are some issues, like I said, that she thought would come up that ended up coming up in the relationship, and which leads to a lot of deceit and secrets.
No, these issues. I guess you can't really go into details. Or,
well, yeah,
are they
from? Yeah, you can't give too much away. Well, but I can tell you. Tell you a lot of couples will be able to relate. I can tell you there will be a lot of
financial
communication.
Wait. There's going to be some folks walking out mad.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
There's going to be some very silent trips home and some very loud ones.
Are you going to have like some, you know, counseling pamphlets or something just in case? That they, you know, as you depart ministry,
Doctor so-and-so.
You know, somebody might end up sleeping on the couch because of this. That's going to be, you know.
No, they will.
Somebody might not have a couch.
What I love
to.
About the way that he wrote it is it's equally distributed. It's not, you know how some people can write and it's not from a fair perspective. Yeah. It's kind of one-sided. I feel like he did a great job of distributing the reality of how relationships work and what can be the downfall, and it's not ever necessarily just one person.
Right.
So I love that because it's truth, and I only want to do work that speaks in truth. So
Before we talk to Mr. Trey, what do you hope, besides the reality check that might have people sleeping on couches or in somebody else's house, they walk away learning and how it can impact?
To communicate. You know, I think that's one of the major things that a lot of relationships just miss out on. Just the simple, it's so simple, but yet so difficult for so many people to do.
That's right.
So hopefully the way this story unfolds, I know for me it has, even in rehearsal, the way it ends and what it leaves you with is thinking, what can I do differently? And one of the number one things that it points out is communication. So that more so than getting mad is what I hope people walk away from, is understanding that we just need to talk to each other.
Right. And do you sing in this? Just I had to ask.
Oh, yes. Oh, my God. Does she sing?
Yes, she sing. You got it. That's a selling
point. Oh, my goodness.
You get your money's worth.
Her voice is mesmerizing. You just are so gifted. I want
to
see the album.
You know you have to give us some acapella before you leave.
Give us something acapella now.
Oh, my gosh.
Come on. Okay, we'll give you 5 minutes. We'll give you 5 minutes.
College your pre-ministry to the married people that will be coming.
That's right.
You know, his eyes on the sparrow. Hey.
Something. Yes. Okay.
Wait, you just told him to
Oh, she gonna sing?
You just told her to do that.
Okay, I told her 5 minutes.
Okay, yeah.
See, we're not communicating.
I know
the relationship is this.
I was like, y'all need counseling. You need to talk, okay? You guys need to talk it out.
Can we talk?
Okay.
You are such an instigator. I know you don't have a problem communicating, Dre.
You also ignored me.
I'll be real quiet just because you said that. Like,
You opened the gate.
He
came in. What?
Hi.
What about your character?
What about it?
Can you tell us?
What you want to know?
How much of it is Trey Ireland?
No.
Who is your character?
My character is actually is Jared. He's actually the one who is the morals, that has the ethics, the right ethics of the play. He tries to keep it grounded. When somebody has infidelity, he tries to ask the person why did they do that. In a job, if it's something that doesn't seem right, you feel like he's working for devils, not white devils, like of our color as well. So it's like, and why are they willing to sacrifice somebody to do something else? And he's always trying to be the voice of reason.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that's it. That's who he is.
Yes, he's always the voice of reason, and it annoys my character.
but he's not married, right? You're the single person. Now, how is that a single person? We always find ourselves as a single person being a voice of reason on the side of the tracks that we've never even, you know what I mean? How does that work out for us? I mean, you're married, so maybe you can relate from when you were single. But I just always wonder, like, you know, we on the other side of the grass giving advice that we know nothing about.
Because we always still have experiences. So okay.
That's what makes you an authority on it.
It's because of experience, especially if somebody's going through the same thing you had gone through. You just give them your experience, and just so they can apply it to what's going on with them, just to educate them on how they may be able to handle it.
Right.
Because they have no knowledge. They're going through it for the first time. You're saying, well, this is my experience with that issue, and you just take whatever you get from that and just to see the signs and to try to either work it out or get away from it.
And he also is a wonderful actor. You know, we have a really intense scene. It's odd before a moment, but it's so intense and quick.
They have some secrets. That's all I'm going to say. They have some secrets.
Now, is your character married in this?
No.
We can't figure it out.
You know, it's funny. Trey and I are actually working on a movie together right now.
Oh, yeah?
We're working on a film together. Assistant Motives? That's the name of it. Jean-Claude Lamar.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we play husband and wife in that film. And he's a good guy in that film as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You a good girl.
Yes, I am. You better you better tell somebody.
That's right. I feel that thing.
All right. So back to Miss Kanika.
Kanika.
Yeah. Come on, Miss Knight.
So
she got the whitest teeth.
Let me just say that.
I'm just Kanika, like, her teeth are
we
so
were in the we both had very tiny roles, kind of sort of in the Marriage Chronicles.
Yes.
By Paul Hanna.
Marriage Chronicles,
I think it was. Right. I know there's a couple of marriage movies and plays out there. So we were in this film together, and she was behind the bar, and I introduced Tony's character, and that was our 5 minutes of fame in that movie. But I remember after that seeing her on Tammy Mack's Mixer Night, and Tammy Mack, for those of you in other countries and other cities in the United States of America, because I know we keep forgetting that you guys aren't all in Los Angeles and we act like you know what we're always talking about. But Tammy Mack is a wonderful DJ on KJLH out here and friend of all of ours.
Mm-hmm.
And she has this mixer night for actors, especially, and directors and producers come. You had all of, 60 seconds of a monologue?
Yes.
When I saw this young lady, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart, do that 60-second monologue. I don't even remember what you were talking about. All I know is after that 60 seconds was over, I was like, my God.
What was it about?
Wow.
We got 60 seconds?
I don't remember what the monologue was about. No.
FCC approved?
It was pretty, I think it was something about a relationship.
Yeah, I actually did an excerpt from Sunday morning. It was
Were you ever married? With all this?
Yes.
Okay, so you're speaking from a place of experience as well.
Yes.
Wow. Yes, but I thought... I knew right then and there. I was like, it's kind of like when I saw Jada Pinkett in A Different World play against her dad. Remember, she had a scene. I don't know if you watched that. She had a scene where her dad came on the show. And when I saw that episode, and it was a real serious episode, I was like, that girl's going to blow up. She is amazing.
Wow.
And so I remember looking at you going, just the right one.
She's a quadruple threat over here.
She really is. So just kudos, Mama.
Yay,
even from that 60 seconds.
That
I'll never forget that. So now, here we are in secret together. Thank you,
so
Wallace
glad.
DeMarie.
I really am. I'm so glad.
Yeah, me too.
I'm so glad.
So are you ready to do a little something for us as the time clicks?
Well, yeah, wait. We should like let that be like the piece de resistance, because we still have to hear about Joey's. Did we get all everything that we needed?
Well, no, we got
character?
Everything, because we done talked to all of it. All these people up in here today. They can't get a word in. Okay, what, Joey? Do you want to tell us about your
character? Trey's a bad influence because he started it coming in.
I knew it.
Trey, you better be texting Jesus. Who are you texting?
Yeah, who
What's
you
going
know?
On?
What are you
He has the Lord on speed dial. Yes, he does. Hallelujah. Trey Allen has Jesus on the main line.
You know she's a mom. She don't miss nothing.
Okay, Joy. The pink.
Okay. Let's go.
I got my pink headphones on and my Israeli T-shirt with plenty of coffee stains. I'm looking good today.
And, only Joey. Only Joey.
I'm just happy to be here with all these talented people.
Tell them about your character, sir. Please.
Okay, I gave you some backstory real quick about me. Now, my character, let's see, where should we go with
Don't
this?
Don't give away too much.
I'll that's what I mean.
On a gospel radio show, I will stab you.
I will
you,
get
okay?
stabbed.
He does that anyway, but maybe just in public now.
You know, like any of the characters in the play, he has his own secrets. And I like him because... He fools himself, and that's what kind of drives me as an actor. I'm always interested in playing characters that fool themselves. I'm not interested in the characters that are going against the bad guy, this and that. I was really motivated because...
Let me say something about Joey.
Please do.
Joey's being nice right now. Joey is actually a super Christian. He was so bothered by his character. We've had many a conversation where
he had to get counseling.
He was just like, I don't know. I really don't know. Like he is a super Christian. Like, please understand that it bothered him to have secrets. Let me just say that. To have his secrets.
Can I say something?
You know, I was a hair from seriously not doing the show. Only because, like, you tease me. But I had to think about it. Because he teased me. He's like, Trisha does all these gospel plays. And I was like, I don't do a lot of gospel plays. Yes, I do.
You know what? I wanted to say, though. I mean, again, I have a degree in Christian leadership. I have several churches right now across the country that any day I wanted to come and be whatever, they would be like immediately. But I'm a very rawly honest person. Mm-hmm. And let me tell you what I found when I completely left entertainment and was 100% in a whole totally Christian world. They had the same problems. Mm-hmm. And they handled them usually the same way. Yeah. And when conferences come into town, all sorts of stuff goes up that's not like porno rentals and all sorts of stuff. No, I'm serious.
I know.
And it's a lot of things. And churches, man, they're really hospitals. Nobody in there is perfect. People are dealing with issues. And matter of fact, if you are a Christian, you're probably dealing with more issues. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Well, let me explain why, though. Yeah. I mean, it wasn't about the issues because we all have them and we all can relate to mm-hmm. secrets mm-hmm. at some point in our lives. Right. You know, it was more about the language.
Right.
Because
right.
it's a lot yes. of language. And so let me be honest with the audience members and let you guys know. Seriously, don't bring your children.
No,
please don't bring your kids if you're coming to the show. We want to promote the show. Do not bring mm-hmm. your kids to the show. Trey Island. No, I'm so serious.
No, seriously. That's
I'm
why
so
you
serious.
Have Ray.
This is adult. No, it's adult. It's 18 years old and over. And for all you super sanctified Christians, please don't come. Because I'm giving you a warning now. It's real. It's raw. No,
well,
there's
know,
not.
No, because it stimulates dialogue.
Let me say this. It stimulates a lot. It alludes to things, but there is no nudity. Don't think that we're sitting up here doing porn. I'm really keeping it real because right. I don't want anyone to come and go, oh my God, they're promoting a show with raw images. Right. I mean, you know, alluding to right. rawness and
will you be
language.
Videotaping it?
So go ahead.
Yes. So that it can,
yeah, yeah,
was
we don't,
run in, go ahead.
We don't promote evil. We reveal it. And there's an evil side to humanity. And we're just putting it on the line.
There you go.
And revealing
that's
it honestly.
Right.
That's
and,
so
I, and I have to say this.
That's exactly
with 3 minutes
why
to go,
I
know we need to push along because our engineer has to go to Capitol Records.
You got
to He
leave.
Has a date. And he'll be like,
we can't get out. 2 extra minutes.
but, you know, I had Pastor Dawn, who does our Word Edition, you know, she... the Lord had to have a conversation with her about, you know, because she was like being Mary Jane. She kind of wrestled in her spirit while watching that show. But the Lord had to tell her, no, you need to know what's going on in the world and how
right,
people are
right,
thinking.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Because there is a purpose oftentimes. And if you see how it was written and everything and you see how the show ended, there's a purpose. And that's just real talk. That's somebody's reality out
right.
there.
It is.
And if you're
right.
so
truly,
stuck up, if truly. You're so stuck up in the heavenly realm that you're
right.
no earthly good.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? What use are you? You a Pharisee. You a Sadducee. You know what I'm saying? saying? Right. Jesus hung out in the clubs and the streets, kicking it with the common man. Right. And he was able to dialogue with them from a place of honesty and truth and realness.
And he led by example.
Thank you.
He led by example. So the thing that I always pray for, no matter what the character is, because all my characters are not going to be good. Actually, I've been having fun doing the characters that are not so good. I'm enjoying it. You know, it's refreshing to do something different than the sweet mom or wife. But here's the deal. My prayer is that whoever is in that audience, every single time I get on stage or do a film or whatever it is, may those people out there be touched if they can relate to who I'm portraying. Mm-hmm. If the person is not that great of a person that I'm portraying, may they see themselves through my character
and
so that they want to be better. Mm-hmm. That's my prayer, you know?
I played a drug addict once, and I had a man check into rehab after seeing the show. And I mean, the character was as raw as it gets. And that was kind of the foundation of why I write the way I do. Mm-hmm. And I knew his family members, so I knew what they were going through. And he came to me after the show and he was like, watching you show me what I'm doing to my family. Mm-hmm. And I'm checking into rehab tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And
that's great.
Anytime that's awesome. People have come to my shows, they always say the same thing. Normally, I'm not a fan of language like this, but it was so honest. Yeah. Like I wasn't bothered by it.
Yeah.
It's the truth. It's what people really were saying. I would never write something just for shock value. If I wrote it, it's because it's exactly what somebody would have said in that moment.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes when you push to the edge, you're not as nice or as holy as you think you're going to be. You know what I mean? Pressure busts pipes. You know what I mean? So we find out who we really are. And for me, that's how I came to know God, was in really raw situations. Like I met God because we didn't have enough food to eat. And God provided food when we didn't have a way to get places. And a cab driver said, ma'am, I saw you walking with this little boy in the snow. And God has put it on my heart. Anytime y'all need a ride, I don't want anything from you. So I met God in very real situation. I didn't meet God in church.
That's great.
Wow.
You know? And so I met God on the streets. And I've met God in ways of, I had someone open fire right at me for no reason at all. 9 shots. There's no reason he should have missed me. He was as close as I am to Kanik right now, unloading, and every shot missed me.
Wow.
And I was like, okay, so I didn't meet God in a very nice way, just being honest about it. I met God in very real life situations. And when he brought me back to entertainment, he said, now all of it has a purpose. This rough life, this life you've been through and all this stuff you've been through, now I want you to share this through stories and different things like that. And I mean, the doors have flown open since then.
I'm so proud.
Secrets, March 21st, 2014. You want to tell them where they can check you out?
Santa Monica Playhouse in the other space or the other room. They can buy tickets on brownpapertickets.com. It's Secrets. It's going to be an incredible show, man.
It's a 2-week run, right?
Yes.
Okay.
The 21st, 22nd, 23rd, 28th, 29th, and 30th. There are group rates available, so if you want to bring your whole church, you can. but I thank God for this amazing cast, and they give so much in telling this story, because a lot of our audience is going to be going through this, whether they admit it or not. Mm-hmm. They've either been through it or they're going through it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And do you have a website that can anyone need to inquire that may be in Australia, Germany, or points beyond?
Nah.
Facebook? Everybody got Facebook.
Yeah, Facebook. Wallace DeMarie. I mean, that's pretty much all I do.
Well, real quick, what's your website?
Oh, yeah. Notnowjohn.com.
Okay. Real quick, what's your website, Trey?
It's Trey Ireland on Facebook, TRAEIRELEND.
And last but not least, tell us yours and sing us home.
Right. Real quick, come on.
All right. KinnickSky.com, KinnickSky.com. Why should I feel discouraged? And why should the shadows come? Why should my heart feel lonely and long for heaven and home? When Jesus sees my portion, a constant friend is he. His eye, his own, the sparrow. And I know he watches me.
Woo!
Amen. Grand Gospel Rhythms. We love you guys. Thank you so much.
See you next week.
Amen.
Bye.
Woo!
Yeah, we didn't think about it twice, lady. And now that the lights are turned out and all of our so-called friends are gone, now all that I have is you. Now, baby.